My name is Yipeng Zhang. We're at the Johnston Lab on the third floor of Mud Hall of Johns Hopkins University. We're looking at the stochastic expression of rhodopsins in Drosophilae, which has a similar mechanism to human eyes. So if we crack this problem and see how different pigments are selected in Drosophilae, we can maybe find a mechanism similar in human eyes, and maybe one day we can treat colorblindness in humans, because in humans, many colorblindness problems are caused by the very selection of pigments. I came from China. My parents are both Chinese, from Beijing, and I came here to study biology, as I always wanted. When I was like 8-ish, my dad bought me a kit to extract genes from pea plants, so shipped all the way from the US, and I didn't read English back then, so I kind of followed the instruction with my dad together, and I got like some gene samples, DNA samples on like a slide, and gave it to my science teacher to look at it under the microscope. And well, I've always been really interested in biology. I remember the first question, legit question that I asked my dad was, what's gene? And since then, I've always wanted to be a biologist. Just done cloning, and then you see some bacterial colonies here. So we want to like pick one colony and then streak it into one of the grids that we drew. And then when it grows into more colonies, we know that the entire, all of the colonies in one grid are of the same genotype. Before I came to college that summer, I went to the Cold Spring Harbor Laboratory just to attend their summer course. When I read the book called Double Helix by James D. Watson, the discoverer of DNA, I read about his story, and then I realized that scientists aren't really somebody, you know, like, they aren't gods. They're just normal people. They, you know, play with girls, they drink, they smoke, they have fun all the time. And then science is not something, you know, we can't touch. It's not something holy. So I realized that maybe I really can do science. I can really be someone like Watson, because it's just something for normal people. Yes, remember the yellow liquid used to be up there, but now they've been spun down because of the force created by the centrifuge. And if you have DNA samples in there, it will be trapped in that white grid over there. I know that people have been putting a lot of emphasis on applied research, like cancer and all that related to human, and Drosophila is kind of going down. All this basic research has been declining these years, but I really think we should put more emphasis on basic research, because these are the things that drive like the very curiosity of science.
Yeah.
And we have to, how to say, understand some more basic mechanisms to see like higher functions in humans. Usually a biological process is very strictly determined by the environment. Like, for example, a cell has certain fate under certain environment. It doesn't usually do some random selection or stochastic expression. So I really want to figure out how does a cell do that? It's easy to think about like nature as a very cause and effect thing, where like you put in one factor, there's a certain factor that's outputted. But when you put in one factor, the outcome is undecided, it's random. Like, how does that happen? It's actually not that normal in nature. Well, I guess many of you like science, want to be scientists, and you, by this point in high school, you probably only, you've only read science in textbooks or like newspapers and stuff. You've never been a part of science. But here, working in a lab, you are a part of that like tip of the spear. That scientific discovery, and one day when the problem is solved, you are a part of it. You know that you have contributed to it. So that feeling of you being involved in science itself is actually really good, because you're not just reading the work of somebody else. You're not just saying, oh, somebody else discovered this. You can, one day maybe you can actually say, I discovered this with all my friends. You did this. So it's actually a really motivating thing to think that you are a part of science itself.